Everyone, well, I know this is not my usual release schedule or style of video, and if I'm honest, that's because I was hoping that I wouldn't have to do another one of these on my channel, because this is not a blind reaction to an episode. This is a knee-jerk reaction to a societal occurrence. Now, I should probably warn you, I am not really well enough to be doing this today, but sometimes you gotta fight through whatever's going on and just deal with a raw whatever event. As I know this is my family friendly channel, I will try to keep this at least PG and keep the swearing down just a bit. Now, anybody who watches my other channel will know what this means, because on that other channel I do a little thing called WTF Vents, which is funny because the T as in a cup of tea. And the general premise is that I have a cup of tea and vent slash rant about something that's going on in the world. And as this is relevant to our fandom world, it's going up on this channel. There may be a version on the other channel, but who knows. Now, if you are even slightly active on Twitter, the chances are you already know what I'm talking about. And basically, that is that certain members of our fandom are being dumbasses. And I know a thing or two about dumbass fandoms. I mean, I'm in the Rick and Morty fandom. I know dumbass fandoms. So it was a little bit of a surprise to see just how bad some of our fandom can be. Now again, if you are active on Twitter, you will know that a director for the MLP show has recently had to close down his Twitter account because some people, a very, very small minority, obviously, who have seen the finale, were apparently not very happy about it, and decided to get in touch with Big Jim Miller to vent their frustrations. Now, first off, it's not inherently wrong to vent your frustrations at a writer or a director of a show, if you are respectful with it. Sending death threats through their business email so they can't avoid them, that is not respectful. That is about as far from respectful as you can get. And let's say it, it is as far from the point of this fandom as you can actually be. You see, if you are the sort of person who will send a death threat, who will send vitriolic, vile messages to someone who worked on a show or wrote an episode because you didn't like it. See, here is the point of the fandom. That's you way over there. That little dot on the horizon over there. That's you. And yes, the irony of being rather angry and vitriolic in a video about not being angry and vitriolic is not lost on me, but that's the way things go sometimes. No, yeah, Big Jim has basically been receiving death threats and vile, insulting messages through his work email and through Twitter and every other avenue that it's possible to get hold of someone. And the reason for this? They didn't like the finale. Yeah? Because someone didn't like the way the show ended. For what it's worth, I have not seen the ending of the show yet, so please don't spoil it. But I'm gonna be honest, unless the ending of the show literally reaches out from my screen and punches me in the face, and I don't mean that metaphorically, I mean literally reaches out and punches me in the face, I don't think I'm gonna be sending any bad messages directed at anyone. And the worst part is, it's not even the first time it's happened. After Philly Vanilli, Amy Keating Rogers, I think that was the name, I'm not sure. But yeah, Amy Keating Rogers received death threats from people who didn't like the episode. And That is just absolutely insanely ridiculous in a fandom about tolerance, friendship, love, acceptance, and generally being together and being happy. And, okay, most of the people who do it are maybe just doing it as a joke or to jump on the bandwagon. But words hurt. You know that old adage, sticks and stones may break my bones, blah, 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 blah. That is absolute rubbish. Because, yeah, sticks and stones may break bones, but words cut so much deeper. Words cut beyond flesh and bone. Words cut down to the soul. And I know that. I can vouch for that. I can tell you that from first-hand experience, that someone criticizing your work, telling you that you are terrible, that nothing good will ever come from you, that has horrid effects. Because I had an art teacher once who did that to me. The reason she did it, she wanted to set an example to keep the rest of the class in line. I enjoyed drawing. I enjoyed art. I didn't draw anything for 10 years because of that woman. So don't you tell me, oh no, it's just words that's going to get lost in the ether. No one's going to take it seriously. It's going to get drowned out by all the positive messages. Those negative messages, one of those has the impact of 1,000 positive messages. One of those, you can be reading good messages sent to you all day, and you get one bad one, one that tells you how terrible you are as a writer or a person or a creative, and that is going to wipe out all of the good messages that you've just read. And I know some people are going to say, oh, but the fandom started on 4chan, so it's okay to do these things. It's really, really not. Now, I'm not going to say anything bad about 4chan because, quite honestly, they scare me and I don't want to piss them off. But what I will say is, if you want to be all 4chan-y about it and want to criticise someone and tear them down because you personally didn't like their contribution, then go and do it on 4chan. Confine it to 4chan. Leave the people actually involved out of it, because your opinions on it are worth so much less than their contributions to it. So if you're doing it to jump on a bandwagon, or because you think it's just a bit of a joke, please think about what you're doing. There is a person on the other side of those comments. There is a person reading those and receiving them. And they are going to cut deeper than you think. And for the people who aren't doing it as a joke, who aren't doing it to jump on a bandwagon, people who are doing it because they think it's genuinely funny to tear someone down, or because they actually think that these people deserve their vitriol because they had the audacity to write an episode that they didn't like, get out of the fandom. You don't belong here. You do not belong in a fandom preaching tolerance and acceptance and being good in spite of everything. You see, I joined this fandom, I think it was around 2013. Season 3 was well underway. Season 4 had actually been confirmed by that point, so it was probably after Season 3 had actually finished. I'm not entirely sure, but anyway, I joined when I was at a low point in my life. I am still generally at a low point in my life, but it's different now. Back then, I had some friends. Turns out one of those friends was actually into the show, and that's how I got into it. They wore a shirt. I asked about it. I started watching the first episode. I got hooked. Here I am. That's the quick and ugly version of how I joined the herd, as it were. But that show, this show that we're all a fan of, it's brought me some of the highest points in my life. I mean, I like a lot of members of the fandom, I suffer from depression, anxiety, panic attacks, and this show and everything that comes from it, as I say, have brought me some of the highest points I've ever experienced. My first convention was Buck 2014 up in Manchester, and wow, the eye-opening experience that was. Before then, I really wasn't part of the community. I was part of the fandom, not the community. I watched the show. That's about it. I didn't really watch any fan-made creations. I listened to some of the music. That's about it. But then I went to Buck 14, and there were all these other people who were there chatting about this fandom that they shared, this show that they enjoyed. There was music there. I went to the Summer Sun Celebration. Can you imagine all of those people just springing around and bouncing and dancing to a song about pastel-coloured ponies? Normally, just it's not something you'd consider would happen. But no, they were there. Everyone was happy. Everyone was having a brilliant time. They were sharing this community. And that, like I say, was an eye-opening experience I will never, ever forget. And after that, I did start taking more of a part in the community. I started going to local meetups. I started watching fan-made creations. And I started to enjoy even more of the community. Like I say, in going to the meets, I have met people that I don't know what I'd do without them now. I've made friendships that I honestly don't know how I would manage if I screwed them up or something happened and I was no longer able to continue those friendships. I'd be lost. There are people I've met online that I have never met in real life that I've conversed with, and you've made me laugh in some of my darkest moments. You've brought me up to feeling like it's actually worth existing. It was the recommendation of one of these friends, just an offhanded, off-the-cuff remark that when a flurry of emotions came out, that I should do a reaction to it. And so I went home, I sat down, I loaded up the episode on my phone and recorded it on my webcam, because I have no idea why, because my webcam recorded at 15 frames a second at 720, my phone would have recorded at 1080 at 50, so I don't know why I did it that way around, but either way, that's the way I did it, and we ended up with the reaction to A Flurry of Emotions, which I still look back on fondly, though cringing all the time, because that's yet another thing that's led me to where I am now. And honestly, this show, the people I've met through it, the dark times that I have helped myself out of simply by watching this show about pastel-coloured ponies dealing with their problems and generally being weird. It's just things that all things that I wouldn't change for the world. All things that wouldn't have happened if it hadn't been for a team of people, including Jim Miller, M.A. Larson, Amy Keating Rogers, all of the writers, the voice actors, the crew, everyone who has been part of this show, part of bringing it to our screens and to our lives, just thank you. I really hope you know, in spite of a few idiots being ridiculously, stupidly vitriolic, how much of a massive positive impact you've had on so many people's lives. So, Big Jim and everyone involved, thank you.